A vector is a set of values with the same data type, or what we see as a column in a data set. This basic R object can be created in R using the C function, which combines the values to form a vector. So let's create a simple vector column called animals and feed the C function a set of values of the same data type to form a vector. So we'll call it, say, animals, yeah, example here. And I'm just going to give it a set of values in the C function. Bird, that'll do. And let's create another vector on the weight of each animal in pounds. And I'm just deliberately going to make this a missing value here. Now, to access a specific element or elements within a vector, we can simply use square brackets, the same we did when we extracted rows and columns in our data frame video. So for example, so this here, this gets us the first element or data value in the animal's vector. We can also get a range of values in the vector. So for example, I'm interested in the first two. And we can apply conditions to vector columns like we did in operators video. So we can also use the length function on a vector, so we don't need to manually find or know how many values are in a vector. We can replace missing values in a vector too, and this can be simply done by, so open those square brackets again, and we want to find anything that is a missing value. In the weight variable, of course. And we're going to replace them, say, with the value 12. And we can do calculations on numeric vectors. So let's say we want to take the mean of weight. We want to average across all those weights. We can sort the elements in a vector. So for example, you might want to sort from lowest to highest if it's a numeric value, or alphabetical order. If it's more of a categorical value, so for example, this sorts it in alphabetical order. You can create a new vector using a range of numbers in a sequence. So let's just create a new variable called class tag here, and we want it to have a range from 1 to 3. And finally, you can organize all your vectors into a data frame. So let's just call our data frame animal data, and we'll use the data frame function here. And within this, we're going to add all our vectors, so animals, weight, and class tag. And let's have a look at this. Okay, cool. And that's the basics of vectors in R. Another important object in R is factor. So let's move on to this in the next video.